माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम फॉर टुडेज वीडियो लेक्चर ऑफ गणित प्राविण्य। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सॉल्व द रिमेनिंग एग्जांपल्स इन एक्सरसाइज 23। ओके, दैट इज एरिया ऑफ स्क्वायर एंड पेरिमीटर, एरिया ऑफ स्क्वायर एंड रेक्टेंगल। ओके, द एग्जांपल्स बेस्ड ऑन द एरिया ऑफ रेक्टेंगल एंड स्क्वायर। नाउ सी हियर क्वेश्चन नंबर 13। द पेरिमीटर ऑफ अ स्क्वायर इज 40 मीटर, फाइंड इट्स एरिया। There is one square, example number 13. There is one square, its perimeter is 40 meter. Perimeter of this square is 40 meter. Listen, here you know, they have given perimeter and we have to find area. What will be its area? Perimeter is 40 meter, then what will be area? So see, basically this example is related with the relation between perimeter and area. Understand? See, they have given perimeter. You know, perimeter means what? This was the separate chapter we have learned before. Perimeter means the sum of all sides, sum of all sides. And you know, we have learned to find the perimeter of square also. Which formula we use for that? Yes, we used 4 multiplied by side, correct? 4 into s, understand? So that was the formula for the perimeter. So what is the relation with the perimeter of area? What is the relation of area with the perimeter? What? See here. First, you know, this is square. Its all sides are different. We know formula to find area of square. What is formula for the area of square? Area of square. What is formula? Side into side. That is S into S. Okay. Means what, you know? To find the area of square, we must know the side, otherwise we cannot find. Understand? To find the area of square, if you want to find area of that square, we must know the side. Got it? Then here they have not given side, they have given perimeter. Means sum of all 4 sides they have given. So using this perimeter, can we find side? Because once we get side, then only we will be able to find the area of that square. Okay, so using this perimeter, can we find side of this square? Yes, we can find. See, what is formula for the perimeter? Perimeter of square. What is formula? 4 multiplied by side. 4 into s, that is 4s, 4 into side. Okay, so see here, in this formula there is side, correct? There is side. Okay, so they have given perimeter, that perimeter 40 meter will put here, 40 meter, perimeter of square is 40 meter, which they have given here, is equal to 4 multiplied by side, we don't know, so s we will keep as it is. Understand? Because we have to find it. Now, as you have to find S, this multiplied by 4, no, we will bring on this side. So, there is 40 meter and this multiplied by 4 will come this side. When this multiplied by 4, when it will change its side, it will change its sign also. So, there is sign multiplication. So, when it will come here, it will be divided. Is equal to, here remain S, that is side. Okay, so now your 40 meter divided by 4, if you divide 40 by 4, what answer will you get? 4 tens are 40, correct? So 4 ones are 4, 4 tens are 40. That means what we know, 10 meter is the side. 10 meter is the side of this square. See, 10 meter, 10 meter, 10 meter, 10 meter, total 40, that is the perimeter. Okay, so when perimeter was given, first what we have done, first we found its side of that square, and now using this side S, once we got the side, Now we can find its area. See here, area of square is equal to what? Side into side. So now we have side, that is 10 meter into 10 meter, correct? And 10 tens are 100 square meter. 100 square meter is the area of that square, whose perimeter is 40 meter, understand? So this is the relation between perimeter and square. Using perimeter we can find area, or when area is given, using that area we can find its perimeter also, okay? Because here also we need side, here also we need side. So if area is given, we can find side, and after that we can find perimeter, understand? So we can do vice versa, okay? Next question, number 14. See here, the perimeter of a square is 32 meter. The perimeter of another square is double of the perimeter of the first square. Find the area of the second square. See, same example, little bit addition is there. Perimeter of first square. Perimeter of first square is 32 meter. Two squares are there. The perimeter of first square, the sum of all four sides of that first square is 32 meter. The perimeter of another square, perimeter of second square or another square, perimeter of another square is, what is that? Double of the first square. Perimeter of another square is double of the first square. So double means what, you know? Double means multiply by 2. When we say I have double money than you, that means the money which you have, that will be multiplied by 2. That means double. Triple means multiply by 3. 4 times. Double means 2 times. Okay. Triple means 3 times. 4 times means multiply by 4. In this way. So perimeter of another square is 2 times of first square. Perimeter of first square. That is 32 2s are 64 meter. So 64 meter is the perimeter of second square. Another square. Okay. Now the question, main question is, find the area of second square. So here now we have perimeter of second square, then we have to find area of that second square. And you know, when perimeter is given and we have to find area, first what we need to find? We need to find the side of that square. To find the area, to get the area, we need side, and using the perimeter we can find side, okay? So see, perimeter of square, perimeter of second square. Here first we will write formula and then we put values in the formula. Okay, 4 into S, that is side. So perimeter of second square is given. So 64 meter we will write here is equal to 4 into side. And to find side, what we will do? This multiply by 4 will bring this side on the left side, so it will be divided to 64. Okay, here there was 64 meter, and this 4 multiply by 4 came this side, so it became divided to 64. So 64 divided by 4, what answer will you get? 4 ones are 4, 4 16s are. So 16 meter is the side of that square, second square, okay? 16 meter, 16 fours are 64, okay? So that means 16 meter is the side of the second square. Now we have got here side. Now we can find its area. Let's write formula for the area. Area of square, you know? What is formula for the area of square? S into S. Side into side, that is side is 16 meter into 16 meter. And 16 16s are 256. You can do that multiplication on the log page. Meter into meter, square meter. Okay. So area of the second square is 256 square meter. Understood? Now pause this video and write these two problems in your notebook. After that, we will see now question number 15. The length of a rectangular hall is 20 meter and its breadth is 12 meter. Its floor is to be carpeted with a carpet whose breadth is 2 meter. How much long will the carpet be needed? See this problem. There is one rectangular shaped hall. You have seen our hall of assembly hall of our school. It is also in which shape? Rectangular shape, right? So such one hall is there. Its length is 20 meter. Length is 20 meter and breadth is 12 meter. Okay? Breadth is 12 meter. Understand? Now this hall, the floor of that hall, we have to cover with the carpet. We have to cover with the carpet. Understand? So, how the length of that carpet or breadth of that carpet is 2 meter. Breadth of that carpet is 2 meter. Broadness of that carpet is 2 meter. Then, what should be the length of that carpet? Understand? Now see, this problem, we have to cover the floor with the carpet. That means what, you know, we have to cover the area of this rectangular hall, cover the area, whole area of this rectangular hall with the carpet. Means what? That means what, you know, whatever the area of this rectangular hall is there, that much carpet is needed. We need the carpet equal to the area of the rectangle. Understand? We need the carpet equal to the area of rectangular hall. Means area of rectangular hall will be equal to area of carpet. Area of rectangular hall is equal to area of carpet. Understand? You know carpet? You know that carpet means what? A rectangular hall, area of rectangular hall is equal to area of carpet. We need carpet of same area like area of rectangular hall. Otherwise it will not cover whole hall. Okay? So with that we can understand that area of rectangular hall is equal to area of carpet, or area of carpet will be equal to area of rectangular hall. Understand? So area of rectangular hall we can find because we know its length and breadth. Okay? Area of rectangular hall is equal to what will be its formula? Length into breadth, and length is 20 meter, breadth is 12 meter. So 20 into 12, 12 zeros are 0, 12 twos are 24, 240 square meter. 240 square meter is the area of that rectangular hall. So whatever there is area of rectangular hall, that much only area of that carpet. Understand? Area of carpet. Okay? So let's see here. Area of carpet. Again, hall is rectangular, that means carpet will be also rectangular. So area of carpet means again area of rectangle only, length into breadth. So here what is given? Breadth of the carpet is given. Breadth of the carpet is given. We have to find its length. Understand? So we know the area of carpet. What is that area? 240 square meter. 240 square meter is the area of carpet. Okay? Because initially only I have told you area of rectangular hall is equal to area of carpet. Understand? So area of carpet means area of rectangular hall, that is 240 square meter, is equal to length into breadth. Breadth is given. What is that? 2 meter. And we have to find length, correct? So this multiply by 2 meter will bring on this side 240 square meter. Multiply by 2 meter, when it will come on this side, it will be divided. Understand? And here remain length. So square meter will be cut. Then 240 divided by 2. 2 ones are 2, 2 ones are 2, 2 twos are 4, 2 zeros are 0, 120 meter. 120 meter is the should be the length of that carpet. 120 meter should be the length of that carpet. If its breadth is 2 meter, then its length should be 120 meter to cover the whole area of that rectangular hall. Understand? So here our exercise 23 is completed. If you have any doubt in this, you can ask me. Tomorrow onwards, our rounds will be started, okay? Tomorrow there will be first round on the first three chapters. That instruction I will give you through the message, okay? So now watch this video very carefully, and today prepare for the tomorrow's round. Revise the chapter 1, 2 and 3 from our Pravinya textbook, okay? If you have any doubt, that also you can discuss with me. Understand? So thank you for today and have a nice day.